Shoes are something that we take for granted every day. When a shoe becomes dirty or slightly worn out, we throw them away. Did you know that there are 20 billion shoes produced every year? That's almost 3 times the current world population. In the US alone, 300 million shoes are thrown out every year. And where do you think all these shoes go? How did this rife shoe epidemic become such a problem? It wasn't always this way. In the late 19th century through the mid 20th century, leather shoes gained in popularity. They boomed in major cities and became popular with many businessmen. Even today, most businessmen still wear leather shoes. But what's great about leather is that when it gets dirty or slightly worn out, you could, back in the day, take it to a shoe shiner or simply wash yourself. Leather shoes can last years while still looking brand new and can take minutes to clean. But then, the first modern mass-produced tennis shoe was created in 1924 by a French brand called Spring Court. After that, many shoe companies you see today, such as Nike and Adidas, followed. I'd been living in Bali for 2 months, and while walking on Brawa Beach, I saw a sandal wash up onto a shore. I wondered, how did that sandal get there, and what were the consequences of it getting there? This led to me to think about the layers of issues related to shoe waste. Most shoes are made out of plastic, rubber, and synthetic material. Coal is burned to create the plastic part of the shoe. When the coal is burned, carbon dioxide is released into the environment, which contributes to global warming. The vast majority of shoes are created in China, 12.6 billion shoes per year to be exact. These shoes are made in sweatshops where kids are paid less than minimum wage. The shoes are then shipped overseas in oil-burning cargo ships, polluting oceans and plant life. Once the shoes reach the store in a gas-guzzling truck, the owner removes the packaging and throws it away. When the rightful owner purchases the shoes are literally dragged through mud, beaten, ripped, torn, half eaten by a dog. Or the lucky shoe spends its entire life in a closet, only to be taken out one day when the owner realizes they don't fit. Okay. Most shoes end up in one of two places, the landfill or the ocean. If shoes end up in the landfill, they release toxic chemicals into the environment over the 1,000-year period it takes to decompose. If shoes end up in the ocean, they pollute the rivers that carry them there. Salt water is actually a great preservative, making the decomposition time longer than 1,000 years. Many fish confuse plastic, the plastic part of the shoe, as food. So when we're eating seafood, we are eating the plastic inside of the fish. Imagine 20 billion shoes added to the waste stream every year. This has inspired me to work on creating my sustainable sandal. My sustainable sandal is made out of upcycled rubber, recycled cardboard, and plant-based 3D printed material. The base of the shoe is made out of upcycled rubber. The sole is made out of recycled cardboard, and the part that goes in between your toe is 3D printed. The first step in creating a sustainable sandal was to cut out cardboard from Kimbali. I then had to make enough cutouts to support a foot. After that, I had to find a strong piece of rubber, which I could later attach to my foot. I had to glue the sides of the shoe, but not the top, due to issues relating to comfort. Lastly, I 3D printed the part of the shoe that goes in between your toes. There are many impediments and concerns that I faced while creating my sustainable sandal. A major problem that arose was using cardboard as a part of my base. Many critics say that cardboard deteriorates when wet, which is true. But my response to this is that I'd choose between comfort and efficiency. Cardboard is the most comfortable, sustainable material. But its downside is that it decays when wet. Another reason why I chose cardboard was that I planned to pour wax all over the shoe, was that as I was doing my research, I found out that wax melts in warm climates such as Bali, which is usually where people wear sandals in the first place. I also had some issues with rubber. I originally wanted to use rubber from tires and not upcycled, which is going to be thrown away. But I also did some research on tires and found out that tires have steel in them, making it extremely difficult to cut out a sole. Surprisingly, 3D printing had issues as well. I had to 3D print the piece of the shoe in a way where it would be sustainable, but also strong enough that it wouldn't break. All in all, my project was a great success, a good step forward in the future of sustainable sandals. When you leave today, what changes will you make? Will you hold on to your shoes for a bit longer? Will you buy leather shoes, which can be easily cleaned? Will you wash your dirty shoes in a sink? All of these changes are small, but can make the biggest difference. Even being aware of issues related to the shoe industry can make a difference. The next time you walk on a sandalless beach, that is a sign we are heading in the right direction. I'd like to thank everyone who helped me work on my quest. Thank you. Thank you.